Dispenser going up.
So I'm going to show you the loadouts I use when I play Team Fortress 2. Let's start with the Engineer, the only class worth playing, because you know what Uncle Dane says? He says you should only play Engineer. It is the best class. In your main slot, your primary weapon, you don't need your shotgun. It's a terrible weapon, terrible weapon. What you need is, you need professional, window washer right here. Yeah, it's a good weapon, it's a good weapon. Then of course in your secondary, you gotta have your short circuit. It's a good short circuit, works every time, especially when your hand's glitched through it, you know? That's how, it's a sign of quality, it's a sign of quality. Yeah. And then your wrench, you can't just use normal wrench, you gotta have a hammer, yeah. Hammer time. That's how I like to play it. Right, so when you're playing as the window washer engineer, you get a distinct advantage, because you can, you get ammo when you do the old shooty pooty boot, and then you waste all your ammo, and then you can't use when building the sentry, you've got to be extremely careful that you don't go above level 2. Because if you go above level 2, your sentry's too tall. In fact, I don't like this sentry. Let's just use this building. That'll stop them. I'll show them what for. Right? Yeah, Uncle Dane. Right, so I'm going to show you the real window washer strategy right here. Just as soon as I find an enemy. That scout. Can't go after him. He's too fast. The engineer's pretty slow. You go. The window washer. Best weapon in. Yep. Just a bump in the road. A bump in the metaphorical road of Uncle Dane. One of the advantages of using the fake hand, my bob, is you can just destroy projectiles. Pew, pew, pew. Occasionally, just destroy them. I don't know how the weapon works. Yes, I do. I'm an expert. Uncle Dane, please. Anyway, let's move on to the hammer part of the loadout. It's obviously the most essential part, because it's what you use to hit your buildings. Look out, watch me use my short circuit right here. Never mind, it's fine. No, it, obviously, it's just another metaphorical bump in the Dane. A bumpy Dane. Dane. Uncle Dane. Doesn't matter, we can progress from this. You just gotta place your sentry gun, you gotta smack your sentry gun, you fool. No, we're not building sentry guns, we're playing the game. Pew! I think I hit someone. Pew! 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 This is where you need your short circuit. Never mind. Don't need it. What do I even have equipped? Obviously you need the capper, yes. There we go, it was my mistake. The capper is obviously much superior. Watch these lasers fly. Maybe I'll get a kill on the enemy. Never mind, I need the short circuit. I was right the first time. Uncle Dane! Uncle Dane! The engine main! Oh, yeah. Oh, I'll get on with my window washer. One of the obvious advantages of this specific loadout is if you press the G key, you can go into a bit of a dance. Yeah. I'll slow down their attack. Look, you wouldn't kill a guy who's exercising. Well, obviously that guy would, but it's just another bump. The third bump in our long journey to become Uncle Dane. Right, so I'm gonna build a sentry gun. Yes? Let me just... hold on. Build a bit of this, we'll go back and get some of the scrap, build a dispenser. Dane! Uncle Dane! Make sure it's only level 2, no higher. There's a scout here. And, I got a kill! That's it, we're done. I got a kill. It proves this loadout is the superior loadout. That is all for now. Maybe? Stupid fucking. God damn, where is it?